What's happening, guys? It's Badnagpal Fry again .in, and today we're going to be reviewing the Motorola Fire and the Fire XT. Both of these devices recently launched by Motorola in India. Both of them run Android 2.3, and they have a bunch of interesting aspects to them, but the fact that they are priced a little over what they should have been is one of the main reasons that they've put us down a little bit. But before we can get into the full details of this, I'm going to be reviewing the new Motorola Fire today, and I'm going to be talking about this device first, and in a follow-up video I'll be reviewing the Motorola Fire XT. So stay tuned for the Fire XT. Right now let's get into the Motorola Fire. The device is priced about 8,500 rupees, and let's talk about the build quality first. The plastics on this device seem fairly cheap, and the best comparison we have with this device is the Andro A70 in terms of build quality, and that is a fairly better build than this. The plastics on this device start squeaking in some time, and we've just been using this device for about 4-5 days. The back panel on this is fairly squeaky. Buttons, however, are very tactile. This camera shutter button is placed in a very weird location. It's a little difficult to use. It's almost like you have to hold the device like this to click a picture. You're already covering half of the device instead of it usually being on the right side, or an ideal location would be somewhere around here. The fact that I have really big hands, it makes it really difficult for me. If somebody has smaller hands than me, it'll be very, very difficult for them to click pictures using this button. Not that you'll be clicking a lot of pictures using this device, since the camera kind of fails to do what it's supposed to, but we'll get to that when we get to the camera section. The screen on this device is also fairly responsive to the touch, and is a fairly nice resolution screen, as you can see over here. So overall, build quality is decent, if not bad. Not too happy build quality of the device. Let's quickly get into the operating system and talk about the basic aspects of the user interface. First, this device is running the latest version of Android, but it's mostly generic Android. You have a few customizations done to the OS to make it look a little bit more snazzier than it's supposed to. So you get your basic widgets over here. You have a contacts widget, which in this carousel fashion, and you get profiles which are preset for your mood. So you get a business profile. So what you basically need to do is set up all these individual modes with your widget selection, and it'll automatically continue to save it in that fashion, so you can just quickly shift from one mode to another mode. So it's great. It's almost like the HTC Sense interface, which lets you personalize your selection. One thing we didn't like in this device is that the overall responsiveness of the device starts to die down as soon as you start to use the device a little bit. And when you move from application to application, you'll find yourself in the need to end applications quite often, because this device tends to slow down. Before I can talk a little bit more about that, I'm going to quickly jump into the browser and jump into our favorite website. You already know that. Google has already searched for that, and I'm already loading that. So you'll see that it loads up all sorts of websites in the browser. You'll already start to notice the lag as soon as you open up the browser and start kinetic scrolling. It starts to stall a little bit. You can also switch from mobile mode to the full website. Pinching and zooming in is also kind of laggy and not as smooth as you'd expect it to be. You'll be able to see that it does not load flash content, and the processor doesn't support that. And you'll also start to notice a lag in the operating system as soon as you start to load up a bunch of things. So that's the browser. It's a fairly decent experience. The display is fairly clear and you'll be able to read web pages, but the overall lack of responsiveness from the device tends to slow us down a little bit. Let's quickly jump into messaging. Right now I'm going to show you that the keyboard is fairly responsive. We don't like the spacing on the keyboard at all, and with big fingers such as mine, you'll be pressing keys that you don't want to. So the keyboard is not as fast as we'd like it to be. The right side keys are shaped to fit the right side thumb, and the left side keys are tapered to fit the left side thumb. And you'll constantly hit these overly sensitive capacitive buttons over here. you prefer using an onboard keyboard, on-screen keyboard, then you can shift from portrait to landscape and you get a QWERTY keyboard here, which is something interesting that Motorola has done. Usually you don't see that on touch and type phones. You didn't see it on the Samsung Galaxy Pro, but it happens on the Motorola, which is fairly good for people who like on-screen keyboards as well. So you get this gingerbread keyboard where you can tap and select and move around the text. You can double tap and select the text. You can copy, paste, replace the text. All those things you can do. By now you'll be able to see that the device has become really unresponsive. It slows down, starts doing random things. For example, I'm zooming in and it continues to zoom out. So you don't get 3D maps on this. So Google also doesn't believe that the processor supports it. You do, however, get standard layers and navigation and all those things, but you don't get the latest version of 3D maps, which is kind of disappointing for this device. Let's quickly jump into benchmarks now, and I'm going to run Quadrant benchmark on this. So as you can see, the device ranks in at a fairly decent 825, which is apparently a little bit more than the Nexus One and the HTC Desire. It seems like a fairly decent Quadrant score for this device, especially considering that it's running only at 600 MHz. I'm going to quickly jump into games here, and I'm going to quickly run Angry Birds. It'll automatically load up the game in landscape mode so that you can enjoy the game. As you can see, even while playing games, there is a lot of lag and the lack of responsiveness from the device, as you'll constantly struggle to get a decent response from the device, and you'll see the game stalling in the middle. So that's something which is really disappointing from this device. I'm going to quickly load up YouTube and show you a video from iGAN. So you can also switch from low quality to high quality in this, and that option is given to you. The earpiece and microphone are fairly clear and the speakerphone is fairly loud. We had no issues with call quality on this device and it managed to sustain a good network. The camera quality is basic and it's not that great at all. In fact, you don't have an autofocus camera, so you'll find yourself constantly struggling to find focus. Also, it is a very standard camera application, just the standard Android camera application, no customizations done here from Motorola, or no custom camera app, which is kind of disappointing as well. So overall, basic problem is that it continues to lag and it slows down as in when you use the interface, and the responsiveness that you get the first time you turn on the device suddenly starts to die down. You get a lot of lagging and crashing in games as well, and while you use the device, that's something which is disappointing. If you ask us for a recommendation, we would not recommend that you buy this device. In fact, we recommend that you go in for something else in this price range, possibly the Android A70, which is cheaper if you're looking for a QWERTY device. Go in for the Galaxy Pro, which is a lot more responsive than this device. For more unboxing videos, reviews and tutorials, log on to iGAN.in, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/iGAN, youtube.com/iGANTV. If you have any questions or queries, log on to our forums, iGANforum.com, and ask your questions over there. We'll be posting the full review on iGAN with image samples, video samples are going to be up, so you can check it out. If you have any comments or feedback, leave those in the comment section below. You can also catch us on Facebook, Twitter and on Google+. The links to those are in the description below or at the end of this video. For iGAN.in, this has been Bharat Nagpal. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the Fire XT coming up shortly.